Hi everyone, I'm Joey Herrington, Senior Project Manager for Soil Remediation and Earthworks. I oversee the excavation we're doing to build the new mouth for the Don River. I'm standing in front of a cutoff wall, a structure we built to keep the groundwater out of the river valley during construction. These also keep the lake water out of the river until we're ready to connect everything. We call those walls the plugs, like you would have in a bathtub. People always ask me, when are you going to pull the plugs and flood the new river valley? Isn't that going to be awesome? Well, I'm here to burst your bubble. Sorry.
When people imagine the flooding of the new river valley by removing the plugs, they're usually imagining something really dramatic. Like this. Or more realistically, like this. We're not doing it that way for a variety of reasons. The main one being that it might end up a little bit like this. Letting the water rush in all at once would also be tough on the river bottom materials and plants we just installed, which are still getting their roots established. So let's walk through what we're going to do instead. We have cutoff wall plugs in three locations. The north plug is where the existing Don River will flow into the new river valley. The west plug is where the new river will flow out into the inner harbor in Lake Ontario. The south plug is where the Don Greenway meets the ship channel. We'll use basically the same process to remove all the plugs. Here's a diagram showing where the new river is divided from the lake. The cutoff wall, or plug, has been specially designed to withstand the pressure of the lake water, similar to a dam. If we cut into the wall with all that force from the lake water pushing on it, water would rush in far too quickly to control it safely. Instead, we'll pump lake water into the new river valley with the walls still intact. This is going to take a really, really long time, like approximately 3 weeks. So you can watch it, but there won't be much to see. Once the water level is about the same on either side, the cutoff wall won't have a massive force pushing it one way or the other. Then we'll use a diamond rope saw or a drum cutter tool to cut the walls away, and the water will be able to flow freely. In some places, we've installed carp gates. These are underwater bars that are too close together for invasive carp to swim through, but they're far enough apart that native fish can pass by and into the habitat that we've built for them. That way, they won't have to compete with the carp. The first area we're going to flood is the Don Greenway. This area is not actually connected to the new river, except during an extreme storm when it serves as the emergency relief valve for the floodwaters that will come surging down the river. Then we'll cut down the south plug and connect it to the ship channel. Once the main river valley and surrounding wetlands are fully flooded, we'll be ready to cut out the west and north plugs. We'll cut out the west plug first. This plug is just east of the new Cherry Street South Bridge that will connect the river valley with the lake. The last plug we'll remove is the north plug, which will allow water from the Don River to finally flow through the new river valley.
We still have a lot to do before we can connect everything, including excavating the path of the river underneath Old Cherry Street and Villiers Street. So I guess we better get back to work. You gotta flip the page. Did I wait long enough for you to edit? It's upside down. We call those the plugs. No. Do we have a pen? Oh, sorry, I just didn't read the right words. No, I'm not angry. I'm not an angry person. No, unless I step on someone's Lego. Don does have the golden voice, eh?